The city of Ham and Lina spreads out beneath the medieval castle of Ham, an impressive historical monument in reddish stones. Ham and Lina is the capital city of the region, located in the southern area of the country of a thousand lakes, Finland. Extraordinary natural surroundings where water and ice, darkness and light are perfectly combined thanks to the kindness of its people. Ham and Lina was the city in charge of hosting the 15th Congress of the International Network of Productive Schools, INEPS, titled Providing Equal Opportunities for Disadvantaged Young People. The Congress was organized by My Own Career Association, a network of training projects that works around the country for the benefit of the most disadvantaged young people. The organizers chose the Hotel Punaporti to host and gather all the participants and to stage some of the workshops and work meetings that took place during the Congress. The official opening act of the Congress was held in the Art Museum of Ham and Lina, where teachers and educators specialized in methodology of productive learning from 18 countries of Europe and America were welcomed by the authorities of the city and representatives from My Own Career Association and INEPS. In this setting, the participants nourished their bodies and souls by tasting of the delicious products of Finnish culture. The anticipated program for this 15th Congress offered the participants the opportunity to analyze and debate once again the subjects of interest in workshop groups. The subjects debated were how productive learning could contribute to a multicultural educational environment, how to train trainers in productive learning, how to deal with drug problems in a classroom through interaction, and possibilities of using adventure pedagogy together with productive learning. Adventure pedagogy is a concept in a well-known method employed by the AAP that all the participants developed in the extraordinary natural surrounding of the EPO National Park. Thanks to a guided gymkhana full of challenges, the adventurers could test the decisive importance of the role played by all the participants in achieving common objectives, the special meaning of values such as cooperation and trust in oneself and others. Why not say it? The human capacity to overcome fear and to get stronger after a fall. An important part of the Congress program was devoted to visit the training centers of the city so that the participants could form an accurate idea of the exceptional courses of the Finnish educational system. The participants visited the Tavastia Further Educational College, one of the biggest upper secondary colleges of the country, where more than 2,000 students between 16 and 19 learned professional skills in more than 30 specialties. Another day was devoted to visiting the Agriculture Division of the University School Ham Polytechnic, where the visitors became acquainted with the Finnish beer-making process. And besides sampling the delicious beer, the first contacts between the INEPS veterans and the new members of the network were established. In fact, Hame Polytechnic kept its doors open to the participants who could use the facilities for most of the activities programmed for the Congress. Besides, other international INEPS affairs, such as the Administrative Council meetings, where its members took advantage of some time to gather and analyze different subjects about the management and work strategies of the network that were later revealed in the General Assembly at the end of the Congress. The Hame Polytechnic was placed where also, for example, the representatives of the National Workshop Association explained the task that they do with unemployed young people with high risk of social exclusion through individual coaching methodology and workshop learning. Experts in these techniques and AP educators had the opportunity to analyze and learn together, cooperating and synthesizing both points of view. These approaches were exhibited in the same center in a poster market full of projects, programs, and case studies. Following the visit itinerary, the convention participants also noted the special education program for young people and adults with physical or mental disabilities and other social problems within the framework of the program Special Vocational Education and Training of the National Educational Board. The participants directly observed these teaching methods in the Kipula Vocational College, Center of Vocational Education and Rehabilitation, located in the outskirts of Torenki. There, the students, besides training for professions in the different productive sectors, receive the education they'll need to follow higher academic courses later, or to get ready for working life through preparatory courses and rehabilitation and guidance programs. The center's teachers and experts provided information for the visitors, divided into small groups, about the different courses and educational programs the school offers. In the same center was organized a workshop, Three Approaches to Learning in Finland, where representatives from different fields, such as the administration and politics, research and education, took part in the act. They highlighted the leadership achieved by Finland in the European study PISA in relation to the qualification level obtained by the students at the end of the compulsory education. The same workshop, Key Specialist in Productive Learning, also studied in depth the basis and history of this methodology and tracked the trajectory of INEPS. On arriving to the end of the Congress, the last day is devoted to the presentation of the results obtained during the workshops and seminars. The conclusions will help the educators to reflect about ideas and sources to be applied in their educative works. Afterwards, the General Assembly takes place. All INEPS members participate in the analysis of the key items of the network, as well as the presentation of new members and new projects for next year. Finland is a country of idyllic landscapes, with an extraordinary light that brightens every corner and reaches the zenith in the midnight sun. A paradise full of rich and stimulating traditions that provoke any response but indifference, as the more daring found out for themselves when they jumped into the freezing water of Alajärvi Lake after enjoying a typical Finnish sauna. Finally, the magic of the past around a table in the darkness of the Hame Castle offered us the occasion to enjoy a splendid medieval lunch. We could not ask for anything else. Ladies and cavaliers, transported to the past for a day. time travelers constantly jousting in the tournament of life, gaining ground day after day for the benefit of young people.
Yeah.